All right, so I got a couple comments on my Evans Kuhn video part one. So recently, and I began comments. I made a video like 2 years ago, and I never made a follow up video for it. Now, part of the reason is because I really, since I have since I had cancer, I wasn't able to ride as much as I used to, and so I really felt like I didn't get a good test trial on it. But I have ridden to where I can at least give you some feedback on it now after 2 years. And I can tell you, so whenever I first decided to try it was because of overheating issues. Now, this bike over here, the 86, I updated the coolant. So instead of being a one-pass radiator system, it's a two-pass radiator system now. So it means the water will flow through both radiators before it goes into the engine. And so, and that was part of the problem with, I think, that one there getting hot a lot. So it has that, and it has the thermometer on it. And so the main one in my first video that I was putting on it for the overheating was a 620. Now, and I also have it on 700 and have it on the 660. Now, at the time, I did some brief research on it, and people said, well, water was better, but it's steam, blah, blah, blah. I mean, a lot of different things on it. So, I just try it myself. I didn't feel like going into a lot of research. At the time, I was desperate for anything that says it might work. So, 620 had overheated. In fact, it blew a radiator hose. So, when I first got it. And luckily, I figured out that happened. And so, I had it towed back to my car. So, I did a couple things. So, I can't really put bigger radiators on this thing. I mean, for a 620, people use these bigger engines in sidecar racing. And sidecar racing, they can put a huge car radiator on them. Plus, they're speeding around a track. And so they have a huge car radiator on them, and they're speeding around a track, so they have a lot more air going through the cooling system, and they're cooling a lot more. But so for me, I've got a dirt bike. I can't put a car radiator on it. I can possibly, these are pretty big radiators, and these aren't small, these are fairly big, especially if I compared these ones to the originals that were on there, because those are the same ones that are on this one. The originals that only went through one side, one was longer than the other, they were thinner, and they were both thinner in all directions. So the depth was thinner, and as well as the height. One was longer, one was thinner, smaller, and then width-wise, they were also thinner. And that's why I actually had to put these plates back on instead of my gas tank that had more gas, because it wouldn't fit, because it was fixed to go around the radiators. I was actually for a CFM 100, it just happened to work on that bike because the radiators were small. But these bigger radiators, so so short of trying to get something, get even bigger radiator and try to get it to work, because I don't really make them for this model. I had to find something and try to retrofit it. But short of going further like that, and then it's still probably not working. Let me try Evans. And so does Evans overheat? Yeah, of course it does. Everything overheats. I mean, it doesn't stop this bike from overheating. So that's what you're wondering. It doesn't stop that bike from overheating. It doesn't stop that bike from overheating. However, I haven't noticed it overheating any more or any less compared to water-based cooling. Now, it is a 620. And so the places where this thing starts overheating are places where I start to get real technical, was usually. If you're not in technical woods, unless it's really hot out that day, you're usually okay. You're usually okay as long as you keep, air going through the radiators. You don't slow down too much. You don't keep it in first. You can ride away to try to get that air going through there. But yeah, as soon as you go into technical stuff, you go logs, you go rocks, and you're going slow. Or you're slowing down. You're using clutch. It starts to overheat, and it doesn't matter what's in there. There's this is a huge engine. There's nothing flowing through these. Now, the benefit in this situation, because then I find the scale benefits. Number one, Evans won't boil over. Okay, now, a lot of people think that, well, it's great if it boils over. In a way, I mean, people are like, well, you can see that the engine has overheated. But the thing is that sometimes you don't notice it boiled over because you have a hose. And on this thing right here, it connects to a coolant in the back. And I didn't know sometimes it's overheating, but it's full of coolant in the back. So I'm losing coolant, and I didn't know it. At times I did know it because the hose blew. So that's another thing, is that if you keep overheating the bike and underheating the bike, or getting close to having all that pressure in there, these hose clamps are more likely to fail. But Evans can keep them from failing a little more because they're not putting any pressure on them. So, take it for what it is. Take that with a grain of salt. But you can always put a higher pressure radiator cap on, but now you're running the engine hotter. Now people say, okay, well, now you don't know with Evans that you're running hotter. And that's not true. If you're only using Evans itself, then yes, that is true. But if you know you have a overheating problem, and part of it is your cooling system, then you have to improve your cooling system. And I can't go radiators, but I can go fans, right? So, there's a red light here. It comes on. And the fans come on. Now, the fans are also hooked up to when the coolant comes out of the head. So that's at its hottest point. I didn't put the detection when it goes into the motor. But when it comes out of the motor, the coolant's at its hottest point. And so at that time, it will come out and it will say it is over, 200 degrees. Therefore, kick on the fans. And when that happens, I know I've got to stop and let the bike cool. So it's not that you use coolant as coming out of the bike and losing coolant that's kind of sloppy. You're losing coolant to determine that you are overheating. Instead, keep your coolant in it, but use a different method to detect that you're overheating. And on this thing, the fans kick on, you get a red light, and you see that, and you're also not going to get burned in your face if it does splash up out of there. So, now that's what I think is the good parts about it, is I don't have to worry as much about hose clamps failing under pressure, because this bike will overheat. If I ride it inside things wreck, this bike will overheat. Doesn't matter what I put in it. It would need to have huge fans, and I can even have the fans on all the time, but I have to turn it off and see if they're kicked on or not. So I can also do that. Of course, I run the battery down. This just doesn't have a stator with power. So, but the main thing here is that so you can still use the bike, or still use Evans coolant to not overflow, but you have a secondary method to detect that's overheating. Now, will the bike run 10 degrees hotter, people say? I don't know. As long as it's running under the coolant operating temperature that's keeping the fan from tripping, should be fine because you're not overheated yet. And once you get to that, you're overheated. So again, usually you can ride it enough that you should be plenty under that, as long as your coolant system is good and adequate. But again, for these big bores, they heat up. And the cooling system, if you're not getting, people think that these water-cooled bikes are just just need water. I mean, I need air too. So if you're not moving that fast and you're going in single track and you've got this huge of a monster of an engine doing that, then you're going to overheat. And so that's what I use Evans for. I use Evans to not boil over so I don't lose coolant. I use fans to try and stop it when it does happen. So I don't recommend Evans. In fact, engine ice on smaller bikes. So just to give an example, this is a 440 Mako. This bike doesn't even have engine ice or nothing, just straight antifreeze, and has the same exact cooling system as that one, actually. And this one never overheats, not even tight single track. I've never had it overheat under any circumstances. So there's no reason to put fans on it at this time, and there's no reason to use Evans to mitigate boil over, because it doesn't happen. So I'm using, in a way, Evans is a band-aid because it's a huge bike. Like I said, it's not that bike was overheating and I changed the coolant system on it first before I ever even tried Evans on it. So if you can, you upgrade your coolant system as best you can, you got fans, and then if it's always boiling over and you're just going to ride it like that, then do Evans so you don't lose coolant. That's kind of my experience. Because it does not stop from overheating. There's no way. But does it overheat more or less? I mean, I couldn't tell. Seemed about the same, but again, it's a 620. It's going to overheat if you're riding it very slow on single track, especially on a hot day. This is a 700. It's going to overheat if you're riding it on a hot day and slow single track. I mean, it doesn't matter at that point how big your radiator is if you're not getting air through this thing. I mean, these things need, you know, constant air through that radiator. So yeah, I mean, the only thing I can do next by this is get a fan that's just always on, and then have a second a method of like hook up a light instead of the fan to the detection, and so I see the light come on and I know it's overheated. You know, and that's what I would do. I mean, because I do not want to ride these things overheated. I do not trust that that Evans is not going to overheat on these bikes. And so, if the battery dies and the fans don't work, I don't ride a bike. You can't ride a bike because you need to be able to know that you're overheating. So, like I said, even with regular coolant, you may or may not know if it silently goes down the hose and you don't see the mist. Because on this bike here, I wasn't seeing it originally because it's hooked up to an overflow tank underneath the fender. So until the radiator hose blew, I didn't know that this bike was overheating. So, and that's why I ended up switching. So anyhow, that's my current opinion. If you're having problems with overheating and there's no way to better your coolant system, I said add trip fans. If it's still overheating, then, well, you will overheat if you're just adding trip fans. So add trip fans, add Evans, and if your trip fans come on, then you're going to have to either rest the bike, which the coolant's going to sit in the cylinder hot and get cool out here. So it takes a while. So put your coolant in the radiators will be really cold in. Or one thing you could do, especially if you're in a place where there's a cool breeze and you have a wider open area, if you bring it to that open area, don't string the bike and just put it in like mid-range at a very high speed where you're not actually screaming it to get the air flowing through there. That can also help, with the fans, can also help cool it down once it starts to get overheated. But again, it depends on the bike and where you're at. And if you're in a place where you can't do that, then you're going to have to sit there for 20 minutes while the cooling from the radiators eventually cools the fluid that's at the top of the cylinder and shuts the fans off. So anyhow, that's my opinion on Evans. If you wanted to know, that's what I use it for. And I don't use it. Otherwise, most of my bikes, I just have regular